Nowadays, people are moving towards ICT tools for generating e-resources and updating their knowledge. The role of technology becomes vital in this situation. To efficiently utilize this time, we had decided to conduct a series of webinars, and based on several subjects we have already conducted. This is one of them, and I'm very happy to announce this national level webinar in current education system. On this occasion, on behalf of our parent society, Lewa Educational Union Jalga, and Dr. Anna Saheb GD Bendale Mahila Mahavidyalaya Jalga, I'm very much happy to welcome our partners and our patrons and our participants. Our college is established in the year 1984 for providing the excellent education to the especially girls students. Of journey, it has become a full-fledged multi-faculty college with several UG and PG programs. Additionally, we have several BVO courses like broadcasting and journalism, photography and videography, filmmaking and dramatics, electronic media, theater and television, fashion designing, beauty therapy, jewelry designing, 3D animation, financial management, sports nutrition, and physiotherapy. Our students and faculty members are always active in organizing various events and complete them with a glory. Today's webinar is also one of them. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the patrons of this webinar, our Vice Chancellor, Professor P.P. Patil, Pro Vice Chancellor, Professor P.P. Mahulikar, Officiating Registrar of the University, Professor B.V. Pawar of Kavayatri Bahinabhai Chaudhary North Maharashtra University, Jalgaon, for always supporting us. I would like to thank a patron and president of Lewa Educational Union, Dr. Subhash Chaudhary, and all the members of Management Council of our Lewa Educational Union. Our special thanks are due to Professor Satish Deshpande, who is always a source of inspiration for us and a guidance, Joint Director Higher Education Jalgaon, who is going to deliver the inaugural address soon. I am also thankful to Mr. Yogesh Pawar, Director Digital EDU IT Solutions Private Limited, and his team for organizing this webinar. At the end of this webinar, you all are welcome to ask the questions to the resource person and make it interactive. I acknowledge for your overwhelming response to this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much for your welcome speech. Dear friends, we are highly privileged to have Professor Dr. Satish Deshpande, the Joint Director of Higher Education Jalgaon Region, who is going to inaugurate this webinar. So may I now call upon Honorable Joint Director Higher Education Jalgaon Region, Professor Dr. Satish Deshpande, sir, to head with his inaugural address.
Thank you, sir. I welcome you all on the occasion of national webinar on digital transformation in current education system. Respected dignitaries for this webinar, the President of the Lewa Education Society, Dr. Subhash Chaudhary, sir, the Principal of College, Dr. Rane Madam, and her team, the university authorities, the Vice Chancellor, Professor P.P. Patil, sir, Pro Vice Chancellor Maulikar, sir, Registrar Pawar, sir, all respected principal, teacher, assistant professor, associate professor, professor, and participant, dear friends. First, I declare that the webinar has inaugurated.
Thank
you. We are aware that since March, we are facing the COVID pandemic situation. Considering this crisis, government time to time focus on the education online processes, so such as learning management system. We know that from 1st August of next academic year, we are going to start the all classes on online system. So organizing such webinar also a need of today's hour. So I congratulate Principal Dr. Rane Madam and her team, Dr. V.S. Patil, sir, Mr. P.D. Patil, and all organizers. We know that the knowledge of online system, it is now very essential to everybody. So the resource person of today's webinar, that is Mr. Yogesh Pawar, sir, is highly knowledgeable for this online digital system. I hope that the knowledge of resource person is highly beneficial to the all fraternity of higher education system, and definitely to carry out the online educational processes in coming near future. For instead of taking much more time in for this all these things, I wish a grand success to this webinar. Thanks one and all.
Thank you very much, sir. We are highly obliged towards you for taking out your time for the inauguration of this webinar. Now, let me briefly introduce the resource person for today's webinar, Yogesh Pawar sir, Mr. Yogesh Pawar sir. Mr. Yogesh Pawar sir is the co-founder and COO at Digital Edu IT Solutions Private Limited. Digital Edu is associated with educational institutes for educational processes automation and technology implementation. Digital Edu was established in the year 2009 with the challenge to bring world-class feature in technology to educational campuses by partnering with performance-minded educrats, educationists, and educators. Digital Edu delivers a fully integrated package of software, hardware, and IT infrastructure as services. Educational setup of any size can start availing their services with zero capital expenditure. So on behalf of Dr. Bendale College, I welcome you, sir, and I request you to now begin your deliberations. Mr. Yogesh Pawar, sir.
Thank you, Patil sir, and for the very sweet and a sweet introduction of mine. And I'm very thankful to Principal Dr. Gauri Rani and the whole organizing committee of Anna Saheb GD Bendale College, Jalgaon, for giving me opportunity to share my thoughts on the very important topic in current era, which is digital transformation in education. So I'm going to share a few inputs. Like most of us are now referring to the ICT, which is information communication technology. So let me split this world when it comes to education. So it's information communication and technology. It's a combination of all three things. So we will have to understand why this term has been introduced in education and how we will have to understand the importance of each word in this. So first is information. So whatever information is related to the educational institute, okay? So how we are managing that information? Is there any kind of a repository for storing this information? Because most of the government organizations, most of the accreditation bodies or auditing bodies or government authorities are asking a lot of information from educational institutes. And it's sometimes become very essential to share this information with the requesting authorities. Second point is communication. So how this communication aspect is considered by all of us, okay? How much importance we are giving this, we are giving to this communication aspect in education. And third component is technology, okay? So how technology is benefiting us in information as well as in communication. So all these things, I'm going to put some light on this topic. Second thing, when it comes to ICT, okay, most of us have directly linked it with the virtual classroom. Yes, virtual classroom, delivering lecture, delivering online lecture, all these things are has become a need today because of this COVID-19. And I really appreciate the efforts which has been taken by most of the educators and educrats for this transformation. 2.5 months back, Okay, we were not knowing the online tools, free online tools, and like most of us were not aware of these things. But as need arised, all of us have suddenly moved to a technological platform to make effective use of our time. And the motive behind this was very genuine and very respectful. And that motive was education should continue. So shiksha rukni nahi chahiye. So this was a motive of each of us, and everybody has participated into that. Everybody has contributed into that. Everybody has involved personally into that. And same way, the students also has faced a lot of change when they have adopted all these things. Like students from this third, fourth, fifth standard, okay, till the students who are in graduate and postgraduate courses. So they have also accepted this change positively. I understand there are certain areas in Maharashtra as well as in India where they don't get the IT infrastructure which we are enjoying in urban areas. Okay, so in some areas there is no mobile towers, in there is no connectivity, electricity is also not reached in some areas. So there we are expecting that internet should reach. So that expectation also we have to consider. So all these things has to be taken in a more practical way when we are adopting this digital transformation, and all practical situation needs to be considered when we are adopting this thing. Second thing is very important. We will also need to conduct the feasibility review. Okay, feasibility from all stakeholders' perspective. So these stakeholders are the students. These stakeholders are the other members who are associated with the educational institute. So that feasibility, technological feasibility also should be under consideration when we are thinking of all these things. Second important aspect which I want to focus on when it comes to digital transformation, it is the communication. So when it comes to communication, now everyone is at home. Okay, at least for till July end, government has very clearly said that educational institute, opening of educational institute, that decision will be taken in next few months, or at least in the end of July, that decision will come from the state governments. Okay, so till that time, or even in some case, some areas, the situation is worst, and it may go till the end of the semester. Okay, so during this case, how we are going to handle our communication with the stakeholders associated with educational institute? So that also, that aspect also needs to be considered. Second aspect is related to the admissions which are upcoming, right? So all these things we will need to take into consideration, small things from administrative perspective. Virtual classroom, yes, it is a very important topic since sir has mentioned that online classes will start from the next months. So the challenge is how these online classes will be made available to the student. Do they have enough infrastructure? What kind of software solutions? What kind of other IT infrastructure will be required? So I'm going to discuss all those things, and I will request all of you to join with me and also share your practical challenges when you're using multiple platforms for meeting your are very effectively using Google Forms, but where this information is getting stored. So that is a big question which will come in near future, that every software solution is storing this information in a distinct location, and how can we club all these things so that we can this information, this data, this things in assessing, evaluating the students as well as for evaluating the operational performance of the educational institutes, because some of this data also needs to be getting audited during your NAC and other audits. So let's think from all these angles. That's my suggestion to you. So I'm sharing a 15 minutes presentation with you. Okay, so after that, yes, I'll give some more lights on the topics which are there in the presentation. Okay, and then we will have a question and answer session. So let's start with this. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the today's session. If the voice is low, I will request all participants to increase the volume. Because some of the participants have raised the concern that voice is low. So please increase your volume. We are going to discuss about digital transformation in education. I am Yogesh Pawar, a social engineer at ART. Continuous improvement, business excellence, and performance improvement is my passion. I am a member of Quality Accreditation Board. I am involved with various quality driving tasks at industrial level as a mentor, consultant, certification guide, assessor, auditor, and coach. I started my journey into education domain for integrating technologies and institutional processes. Since last 10 years, I am serving in education sector as a founder member of Digitality. Currently, I am heading operations, and which gives me opportunity to meet educators and educationists pan India for resolving their challenges. That brings me here to help you in dealing with the current challenges of education industry. Let's have a quick look at the agenda points. Never before in human history we have witnessed educational disruption at this scale. They say sooner or later many of us will get affected by the virus, and 90% of affected will face no or lesser medical situation. It is forcing us to change our legacy processes. We as educators, educrats, educationists need to go back to drawing boards and relay out our institutional processes. I welcome you all to join with me, and let's understand the impact and the solutions from technology point of view. We will need to live with Corona's bad effects, containment zones and quarantine centers. Movability of resource will always be doubtful for first semester in the academic year 2020. Due to all these happenings and uncertainties, administrators of educational institutes are under tremendous pressure. Complete adoption of digital media and total give up on paperwork is only way out. More than physical infrastructure, we need to focus on being with best digital infrastructure. Digital transformation is need of an hour. Corporate light approach is must for day-to-day chores and process automation. Over the years, we all have worked not to change or to change minimally for our administrative processes when it comes to education. What I'm trying to say is, even if we adopted automation, we will have to keep hooks for paper trial and human checks. We have never imagined paperless colleges and schools. To meet up these challenges, only technology has the best answer. We all need to respect, learn, and adopt the new processes for our own success. Technology is not integrated if it's not linked with our tasks, and it will only add up to the work that is not really helpful in long run. These are the six major sections where technology will surely help and will be useful for each educational organization. Let's take a detailed view of each as offered by our ERP MIS system, called as SIMS, Student Information Management System. In my view, when even some of staff members are working from home, communication becomes a very important aspect which might have been overlooked. Communication will become bottleneck for all quality and performance oriented tasks. Task manager can be the best tool for monitoring peer-to-peer collaboration. As everyone is working from home, efficient communication system will make life more easy and will speed up operations. SIMS covers communication over mobile app, web portal, SMS and email. What it means that any notice, alert, message, GR is communicated to respective stakeholders in more than one method, that is app, portal, SMS and email too. If admission is not made easy and available from home, then enrollment for the year may drop, leading to heavy impact on workload and teacher-student ratio. We have devised an efficient admission process that is very easy, intuitive and quick. SIMS covers all aspects from admission inquiry management to roll number generations and ID cards too. Digital Edu has designed the system which is highly configurable and very modular. This means that based on the needs of institute, we can change various steps and depth of information needed from admission seeker very easily and quick in time. We support digital document repository to get rid of handling papers and documents. As a statutory requirement demands, we keep track of reservation quotas, scholarships, and provisional admissions too. Roll number generation utility can be configured to generate alphanumeric roll numbers based upon the requirement of each course or class. For admission from home, online payment and respective record keeping becomes very crucial. One of the important goals of admission process is to assign and collect fees. Fees can be paid online by students using net banking, debit credit cards, UPI app and wallets too. We offer a complete set of communication friendly tool for requesting and approving partial payments and installments in the fees. Bank reconciliation utility works like a breeze to map out target and collections. We maintain all records of student balance and fee dues with the dates. Overall, this information can be then imported into systems like Tally or any other accounting software. Various popular streaming tools are available for delivering lectures. I'm very thankful to those companies who are offering it free for education. But it also has increased our way by means of manual setups, creating meeting requests, distribution of links, timetables, and keeping up all the required discipline issues. There are various other things that might be needed for continuous student engagement, encouragement, and tracking. It's just not enough to deliver lecture over a video call. Yes, I will repeat. It's just not enough to deliver lecture. You will all agree with me that all students are not same. Some need tight tracking, some need boosting, some need regulations, and some need to learn at their own pace. Whatever is the identified need, adopting our learning management system will solve all these issues. In these times, live classroom seems like a very important tool. Same is true for e-attendance, educational networking, student engagement tracking. Young generation used to electronic media for all socializing and entertainment. Educational networking pivots on this. I'm very sure even if we move out of the danger zone of COVID, still a progress-minded educator will keep balance between classroom and digital learning management system. We all call this as a blended learning environment. Going paperless, we will have to change the way we give homeworks, the way we collect assignments. Through SIMS, homeworks or assignment tasks can be conveyed to student via mobile app and portal. SIMS also has a provision for uploading the completed assignment and making it available for the teacher for evaluation. Timestamp of uploaded file will help in keep the track of on-time submission. We will also need to find out new ways and means of assessing students. Not only it needs to get electronic, but also it needs to move into mobiles. Please note, mobile is more than a computer. Surprise quizzes can help to check track activities and understanding. If needed, internal assessment can now be spreaded over multiple surprise quizzes. As quizzes gets evaluated automatically and system remembers the marks given to the concept, the continuous comprehensive evaluation can be extended to the surprise quizzes. As the graph of victim is rising and all were busy in adjusting the pandemic situations, some authorities have cancelled the exam and might be an okay decision. But this can't be new normal. The new normal can be electronic exams. Potentially, this can be the most significant piece of transformation COVID can bring in our mainstream education. Exam from home is not a just concept anymore. Who knows, maybe the end semester exam would also be needed as exam from home. Our system is equipped to conduct MCQ as well as descriptive answer exams. SIMS can also handle evaluation from home, wherein teachers get to see entire answer paper on mobile for each answer and answer-wise on-screen evaluation. The best part of this is that exams can be conducted reliably over the poor internet connection also. Surveys and feedback works as backbone of healthy progressive system. Regulatory authorities like UGC, AICT encourage natural surveys feed and feedback system for grading through the instruments like NAC and NBA. While the paradigm is shifting, as we are preparing to work from home, it is important to maintain all goodies that were being followed in regular days. In case of assessment surveys, we need to keep doing them frequently as mode and method of education is changed and learning curve is involved for all. Digital Edu recommends taking surveys more frequently than before. Continuous evaluation of situation is must for assured success. Digital Edu SIMS has lot more to offer when it comes to NAC and NBA implementation. It can be a topic on its own for another webinar. Digital Edu is equipping universities, autonomous institutes, educational trusts, and colleges with an robust, secure, scalable, and evolutionary process automation engine. We call it as SIMS, Student Information Management System. SIMS is all-in-one platform and end-to-end student lifecycle management. MIS, Management Information System, and ERP, which is Educational Resource Planning. As a first step towards digital transformation, adoption of SIMS is helping institutes in revamping entire organization, its process, people, and culture too. Every organization has used automation, but it has kept hooks for paper-based processes. Now, in new scenario, all operations have to be fully paperless. We have added new facilities to SIMS for turning institutions into a full digital operations. SIMS take care of all operational needs of all stakeholders like management team, staff and faculty, as well as teachers. It also takes care of communication, collaboration and convenience for students and parents. Despite the differences that exist between organizations' environment, Digital Edu has proactively identified, studied, analyzed, proposed, and developed case studies to improve the success factor. Digital Edu's mission is to enable world-class management standards at all educational establishments in India through technology. We strongly understand the concept of Eastern Economic Edition. We truly want to facilitate this journey of masses into classes via education. We are currently working with 125 plus institutes. We have developed a technology platform that covers all needs of any educational establishment. Automation of daily chores is our specialty. We offer free trial session for everything. Understand, evaluate, and then implement is our clear policy for handholding with educational institutes. Yes, participants, so we have till now whatever I have shared with you was related to the digital transformation from administration perspective. So we discussed in detail about admission automation, because most of the universities in Maharashtra might be taking this decision of online admissions. Already Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University has released a circular for conducting their admissions via online process. So there will be some practical challenges also, and those I want to bring it to your notice that when it comes to online admissions, are we expecting students to make use of the laptops and computers for filling up their admission forms? Or are we expecting that they should go to the internet cafe, nearest internet cafe, and they pay the fees there? And normally the internet cafes will charge them 100 rupees or more than that also. So according to me, we all should brainstorm and make a system which will be which can be handled through one single platform, a small computer which is a mobile phone. So Digital Edu has come up with this concept of admission from home, where student as well as the staff member both should operate this process from the small screen. Okay, so all such practical things we will need to consider even during the exams, because since the lectures will be getting conducted online, so there will be a requirement of continuous assessment of the students. Okay, because of the other challenges of engagement during this online lecture delivery. So how we are going to overcome these challenges and what platforms we can use? So the Digital Edu is sharing our experience with all of you, so that these challenges of using various different software solutions, which I think everybody is going through it, and for every different need, we are searching for a best free application which is available on internet and making use of it. So I appreciate this effort, but over a period of time, if it continues for a longer duration, say at least for next term, then what will be our stand, and is there any kind of a common platform available where all the needs of educators as well as educationists can be fulfilled? So that's my input to you all. And one more thing, that when we come discuss about the learning from home, okay, so during that phase, we will also needs to continuously assess the students. Okay, so during lecture also, is there any need to assess them? Is there any need to assess them on a weekly basis? Since they will not be in physical connect with you, and they will be at home. So all such aspects needs to be considered. Plus, how the NAC and NBA audits will be happening, and how we are going to lay down the foundation for the management information system, which might be required in coming future, because everything will go online now. Okay, so for all these things, I would like to request participants to raise their questions. They can raise their hands. I will request them one by one. They can unmute their mic. So Ms. Kumud, you can raise your concern. You can raise your question. Ms. Kumud. And there is one more person. The name is not appearing. Only the mobile number is there. 765BE187. Yeah, please continue, sir. I'm not able to hear you. Hello, Miss Priyanka. Hello. Hello, Miss Priyanka, can you see, I'm not able to hear you, Miss Priyanka.
Hello, Priyanka. Hello.
Hello.
I think she's having some problems.
Excuse me, Yogesh Pawar, sir. Sorry for the interruption. I think we should ask the participants to write their questions in Q&A section, because I think there seems to be some audio problem.
Mm.
If we do that, then we would be able to see the
Mrs. questions. Mrs. Priyanka, I think I'll make you host.
Hello, sir. Hello.
Hello, Priyanka.
Hello.
Ah, sir. Hello. Sir, am I audible? Hello, sir.
Priyanka, I am not able to hear you. I have made you host. I will join you in 1 minute.
Okay, okay, sir. Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
All the participants can just write their question in question and answer panel. Hello. The name is Kumud. Hello. Hello.
I think she is not there. You can move to the next question.
Okay. The next person I am seeing, the number, the name is not there. 354788.
Yes. Yeah.
Hello.
Thank the you, numbers. Priyanka. Yeah. So anybody from attendees, Ms. Kumud?
Sir, we have question in question and answer panel.
Okay, fine, fine. I'll refer that.
Question is Thanks. From Aarti Sher.
Aarti Sher. Okay. Yeah, you can allow her to speak. You can search her name and you can ask her to, or you can make me host. I'll do that.
Hello.
Yeah, Miss Aarti. Yeah, please continue.
Sir, I'm Rupali, not Aarti.
Okay, sir. Yeah, please continue. Your name is not appearing. That's fine.
Okay. Sir, my question is, online teaching is affecting the recruitment of professors in colleges?
How do you, how does it affect the recruitment of professors? I don't think so. Because whatever situation we are facing now is a temporary situation.
Yeah.
And over a period of time, even government is also thinking of giving it as a blended learning approach. So the Marathi sangaycha mhatla tar guruchi jaga dusra koni gheu shaknar nahi hai jar tasa kahi manat prashna asel tar. But recruitment will affect this, I don't think so. Yes, at least currently not.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, and what we need is more improvements in teaching learning process. So in the past 2 months, we all have experienced a lot of improvement in teaching learning process. Okay, so all these goodies we should able to utilize, we should be able to make the effective use of all these learnings. That is for students as well as for the professors, so that the next semester can be better, because there will be a lot of stress on the students as well as teacher for executing the operations for this current academic year. Okay, so we should be able to make use of effective use of technology
to
reducing our operational burden.
Okay.
Yeah.
So anyone wants to enter in this field for teaching. So means I'm searching job in teaching. So I search in many colleges. So they just reply me like there is no recruitment now, and many colleges share like this. The teaching is online now. So.
Yes.
The new candidate, how they will enter in this field?
The new candidates will enter in this field with a new innovative concepts. Okay, so the young team who is currently pursuing their graduation and post graduation in the stream of education. Okay, so they all have to equip themselves. So because whatever is happening now was not a part of your syllabus. Okay, so how you can adopt all these changes very fastly, and I'm very sure that the young generation will adopt it more better way. Okay, there will be some challenges for the professors and teachers who has accidentally accepted it. Okay, they struggled a lot to adopt all these things, but for young generation, I don't think so. It will be challenging, and they can come up with their own innovative ideas of doing the things, right?
Yes.
There was a lot of challenges you might have faced, like if you refer the news and all those things. So there are health issues which are getting discussed with the online learning. There are the engagement and involvement issues which are getting discussed with this online learning. So my request to the young generation or the young professors, young teachers is, let's collaborate and find out solutions for overcoming all these challenges, and which will really make you stand ahead of the other members.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Any other person? Anyone else? Miss Aarti AAR. Okay, Aarti Sher, you can ask your question. I have unmuted you.
Yes.
Hello, sir. My name is Aarti Sher, as you have read it already. Sir, my question is how to assist students as if we are doing online teaching, virtual teaching, whatever you call it. But then how to assist a student? Because I have tried it with Google Forms. And the thing is ki I, only, you can say 5% out of that, the students have replied. So the thing is that engagement, as you said, engagement is quite a task over here. Because in the school, face-to-face or in the college, it is very easy to find out whether students are understanding or not the concept. But when we are on the virtual platform, it becomes very difficult to gauge whether what we are teaching is they are able to, you know, understand it, grasp it, and that. Now, regarding this online assessment kind of thing, I tried with the Google Forms, which I had kept it open for a day's time. But there were hardly any feedback that I got. And students who did well, only those students had given the feedback that I missed. So what can be done? Like, what next can be done about this?
Yeah. Aarti, first of all, it is a very nice question. And most of us who are making use of this online platform, okay, so they are facing the same challenge, okay?
Correct.
There is, only thing is for giving you an answer, you will have to just change, just think quietly when you are conducting a class, when you are interacting with the students, okay, in the classroom, how you are involving them. Can you give me one example? So, what's your process?
So it is like most of the time, say suppose there is some chapter that we start with to begin with, follow. At the same time, what I do is say suppose there is some slides which I share with the student.
Perfect.
Now on the slides, they, if it is maths, because my subject are maths and science, so at times I give maths problem, one or two problems, which I ask them to note it down in their notebooks and try to solve it there itself during the 40 minutes class. Okay.
Right.
And then the thing is, as you know, the Zoom frame, we can only see very few students, and some students, obviously, they keep their screen off also. So two, three times what I did, I asked them, whatever you have solved, just show me on the screen. So the on the screen where I'm looking at them, I could see few of them have solved it. So this was one way I did. Then there was some questioning, a question and answering thing, which I did.
Yeah, Miss Aarti, sorry to interrupt you. There is some noise at your background. So can you avoid it?
Okay. Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. Yes. So it was like that. Question and answer session. At that time also, there were very few students who were answering.
Yes.
So
yes.
I couldn't understand whether all students were involved, whether they're there, if their laptop is just open and they must have gone somewhere. You know, it becomes quite a task to find out on the other end. Yeah.
So this is a common challenge. Okay.
Yes.
See, what we will need is, okay. See, students are smarter than us. Okay.
Right.
In terms of the technology. Okay.
Right.
And we all have to accept it.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And when we are dealing with such a smart audience, we will also have to be equally smart, and
smarter.
We have to change the way we are assessing them. Okay, so very simple thing is, one of my customer is using this concept. What they do is, when they are delivering lecture through our platform, our virtual learning platform, they define the random questions. Okay, so those questions appears on the screen of the student after a random duration, and the very short time span is given to the student for answering those questions.
Okay.
So it's kind of an yes or no question or true or false type of questions where student has to read that question and quickly he has to answer that question.
Correct.
The output of this 5 to 6 questions is further assessed for marking their attendance.
Correct.
ओके अभी इससे क्या होता है ये सॉफ्टवेयर अपने आप करता है बैकएंड में
ओके
इसके लिए टीचर डज नॉट हैव टू कीप एनी बुककीपिंग एंड इफ इट कम्युनिकेटेड टू द स्टूडेंट दैट योर अटेंडेंस विल बी मार्क्ड बेस्ड ऑन द अटेम्प्ट ऑफ दोस क्वेश्चंस व्हेन आई एम सेइंग अटेम्प्ट आई एम नॉट बॉदरिंग अबाउट वेदर दे हैव आंसर्ड इट राइट
और नॉट
यस सो इट्स ओनली अटेम्प्ट एंड सेकंड थिंग इज इफ दे हैव अटेम्प्टेड इट एंड इफ दे हैव गिवन अ रॉन्ग आंसर ऑफ इट ओके द सिस्टम शुड pop up and suggest that you have given a wrong answer buddy the right answer is this
okay
so, such kind of interaction such kind of involvement can be improved by making use of technology
yes correct.
Second thing is when it comes to assessment it has to be system driven when student knows it that it is from the Google form they will try to fool you but when they will know that it is recorded in a system in the database of the school that how many lectures I have attended how my attendance is getting marked how the quizzes I have attended how the assessment I have attended and one more thing during the assessment it's not only the multiple choice questions which will serve the purpose
correct
there are certain subjects where we will also have to assess their writing ability So your system should be equipped in such a fashion that their writing ability also needs to be assessed.
Correct.
So all these things, when you blend together, then it will give you a complete solution, a complete satisfaction of evaluation of teaching and learning.
Correct.
Okay.
Yes, absolutely.
And that is needed in the online learning platform. And I think when we are using Zoom or Google Meet or the other tools, these aspects are missing because these tools are primarily developed for the professional
meetings and conferences.
So it is not serving the purpose of the educational institutes. So it will need a blended platform and that is with the collaboration of educators like you. We are happy to offer that platform on a free pilot mode to the institutes.
Thanks,
Arthur.
Thank you, sir. Yes.
Anyone else? Anyone else from this side? Okay, so one more person I have allowed him has raised the just hand 61D5E1B4. So this is a name appearing on the screen, my screen. You have raised your hand. You can ask your question. Anyone else who would like to ask question? Dr. B.S. Pawar, there are many principals, there are many assistant professors who have joined with us. So they can also share their challenges, what they are facing. And let's discuss those on a common platform. So it's an opportunity for all of us. Yes, Mr. Vikrant Alegaonkar, you can unmute yourself.
Yes, sir. Can you listen me?
Yeah. Please continue.
Sir, I want to ask the question that now we have started this online learning, but is it possible for all the students to come on the this online learning? Because few students do not have internet facility. They are poor. Hello, can you listen me?
Yes, Mr. Vikrant. Your question is very touching to my heart.
Yeah.
Please continue.
And second thing is that is about the poor student. And other thing is that there are so many students. They get the facility, but their parents are worried that their children are not learning at home because they have no fear of teacher. Like no one is observing and all, and they do not listen to their parents.
Yes.
So some students are they can do it by themselves, like textbook also. Online learning, they have that intention to learn. But what about these students? What do we can do? But same thing, if they come to the school or to the college, then we can handle them. Teacher can handle them. But online, it is very difficult.
Yes.
So see, this question is there. I know that we cannot give the answer to this thing.
Yeah.
We can just warn them, or we can contact to their parents and all. This thing we can do. But beside that, we cannot do, I think.
Yes, you're right. So the second part of your question is connected with the accountability of the students.
Yeah.
Okay. So in the whole teaching learning process, what is the accountability of the student? That is still questioned. Okay. And we all have to deal with it very cautiously, because some of my friends or some of the attendees might be from the schools and some of from the colleges. So there will be different ways of handling it. But this aspect of student accountability in teaching learning process would be a different topic itself for discussion. But that has to be there when teachers are taking really a serious efforts, very hard efforts they are taking to transfer the knowledge during this pandemic situation over the online learning platforms. So on the similar grounds, we will also have to find out the ways and means that how these things will be considered. Okay. I have given in my last answer, I have given you a few. It's not a solution. It's a hints I have given to you that how the accountability of students can be monitored. Because once you start monitoring, slowly, the students will come into mainstream. Yes. So that's my suggestion to you. The first part of your question was related to the students who do not have this IT, such kind of IT infrastructure. Yes, I am with you. And as I mentioned, this is a very touching question I'm getting in every alternate webinar which I'm conducting. Okay. And see, India is a developing country. Yes, IT infrastructure is not uniform across India. Even in urban areas, the quality or consistency is differing. Okay. So the rural part of India, I'm really worried. At my hometown, I do not get the required quality of internet. So that's the fact. So to overcome all these challenges, we will have to make use of the tools which will give them a platform to the students where they can learn at their own pace. Yeah. So this is a new phrase which is coming in picture, because Zoom, WebEx, Google Meet, all these tools have been designed in such a fashion and with a basic understanding of consistent internet connectivity. Yeah. Okay. In Western countries, it is very well possible and the expectation is not wrong. But in India, it is not practical. And that's why the online learning via Zoom, WebEx and Google Meet may not be that much affordable. I'll use the word affordable for the students across Maharashtra, across India. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So we will have to give them some kind of a blended learning approach, some kind of a platform where they can refer the contents later on when they get connectivity.
Okay. And even we can send them the material through email or all. That also we can do.
Correct. Yeah. And again, the question will come if you are sending it through email. So one document is going through email from one teacher, other document is going from a teacher, or it might be a video. So can we make it a reusable? So whatever medium you are sharing, whatever media you are sharing with them, can student reuse it multiple times? Okay. Because the understanding level of each student is not same. So if I doesn't understand Pythagoras theorem in one go, I should get a chance to see that video multiple times. So can we give them a platform where all such things are gathered together, subject wise, period wise, class wise? So ऐसा कुछ हमें जरूर सोचना पड़ेगा ताकि ये स्टूडेंट फ्रेंडली हो.
That video should be minute level.
Yeah.
So that each and every student should understand that.
Correct. Topic, subtopic wise, if we can able to share it through a common platform, like along with the video, you will also need to attach a questionnaire that if you have gone through this video, please answer these 5 questions.
Yeah.
So something like this will be required.
There has to have a spirit from both the side.
Yes, spirit will be there. Spirit will be there because student understand the competition. Okay.
Yeah.
We have to use a proper tool for delivering all these things to the students. That's my message to you.
Yeah.
And it has to be one common platform.
Yeah. Right. Yes? Right, sir.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yes, Aditya Nagre, you can continue, Mr. Aditya.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am. You are audible.
My question is that I'm listening this webinar right from the very first moment, sir. I'm assistant professor in Bandale College, sir, for the commerce. Sir, my question was that we have find out the solution for the admission as well as for teaching learning. But other than teaching learning, it needs that the student should be participative in the cultural activity as well as many of the activities such as MSS, NCC. NCC, we need to have a parade practically, that is on campus activities actually. So these are the things where that is also very much essential for the overall development of the students, sir.
Means correct.
Activities, right, sir? And even the NAC asking for this type of things, sir, in the different criterias. So how IT solution or this online can be the solution for such type of activity? This is one question which has come into my mind. So what can we do for this, sir? Because overall development of students, this is also one aspect we should consider. So how it can be possible, sir?
One of our customer who is a college of physical education.
Yeah.
Okay. So what they are doing is they are giving assignment to the student. And the assignment is what I'm sharing with you. It might find unexpected to you, but it's a fact I'm sharing with you. What they are doing is they are giving assignment to a student for 15 minutes. Okay. So duration is 15 minutes. And the assignment is they have to conduct certain activities within the 15 minutes time. They have to shoot a video and send it to them as an attachment, as an answer to that assignment.
Okay. Fine.
Yeah. So this is the way now we can engage student, we can involve students in all these things. This is just a solution which is adopted by one of our customer I'm sharing with you. So if you can able to adopt anything like this, yes, my system is ready to do these things. And even in you mentioned about admissions and learning, that is, please continue.
Yes, that is there. I have seen the webinar from the very first. This is there in your presentation, that admission is there. But I was concerned about how to go for the cultural and NSS, NCC activity for the students.
Yes, for this current semester, there would be some challenges. But hopefully, from the term 2 of 2021, the situation will get normalized. And this problem will get solved. Because you rightly mentioned that the aim of education is not only gaining the knowledge, it's the overall development, physical, mental, emotional development of the student. Okay. So by online thing, we are only transferring the knowledge, transferring the information. Sorry. It's even not a knowledge. Right?
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Anyone else would like to participate here? Anyone from panelists also can join me? Mr. Manoranjan Chaudhary, please continue. Anyone else who would like to ask can raise their hands.
Sir, I will ask and say something, but let participants first finish.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, yes, yes. So, Manoranjan Chaudhary, you can continue.
Well, sir, can you hear me?
Yes, you are audible, sir.
Okay, sir. My question is, India is comprised of rural areas.
Absolutely.
So, main problem is connectivity.
True.
We're telling something regarding poor connectivity, how to conduct the classes with poor connectivity.
So I have, I think, addressed this in my last question, but I'll repeat it for you. See, the tool which we are using now, Zoom, WebEx, Google Meet, all these free tools are available for conducting the online lectures. And the basic necessity of all these tools is they need a consistent internet connectivity, even in between. Okay. So all this software has been designed with a basic consideration that every user will have the consistent internet connectivity, but that's not the fact in India.
Right, sir.
Okay. And especially, as you mentioned, that rural part of India is not well connected in terms of IT infrastructure. Right.
Sir.
So during such case, we will have to choose some other better option, which will be affordable, which will be adoptable by students, even in low internet connectivity. So the solution is, instead going for the online delivery of lectures, okay, even after the COVID impact is over, what you can do is, you can make use of your mobile phone, keep it on a desk when you will be conducting lecture in your classroom, and shoot your own video. Okay, shoot your own video of teaching in the classroom and share that video right away with the students from a platform where they can able to access that. And this will be also beneficial to the students who were not present in your class. So that I am telling you after 6 months, but same concept needs to be used in current scenario where students do not get live internet connectivity when you are conducting a lecture. So your video should be available to them offline. And please understand that it will be your own intellectual property. Okay. So how you are going to share it with them? So is there any secured platform available to share? Along with that, you will also need to share the notes. Along with that, you will also need to share some assignments to them. So we will have to come up. We will have to analyze our own needs and find out a better solution which will collectively fulfill all the needs of educational institutes. So starting from the pre-admission process, attendance, note sharing, syllabus planning tracking, for some of the NAC accredited college, it's a POCO mapping, then quizzes, examinations, assessments, mark sheet generation, everything can be do it on online. It is possible. And if it is a need for next term, are we ready for that? That's my question.
Sir, right now.
Pardon, sir?
Is there any platform where we can operate all these things securely? Means,
yes, sir.
Not aware of all.
No. That's what I'm sharing with you. The platform is available and it is being used and appreciated by most of our customers. We are providing these services to the educational institutes. Okay. Currently, the focus is on the free tools available online. Okay. We will have to shift our focus from the free tools to the best affordable tools, which can meet both the ends.
Because apart from this problem, most of the students are poor also.
Absolutely right, sir. The
main concern, sir. Main concern is both the data connectivity that is poor, and the many of the students are very poor.
Yes, yes, yes. There are few students who even not able to pay their fees.
Right, right. Very correct.
That kind of students are there. That kind of students are there. And see, even in Pune, in foundation, you might be aware of Sakal Foundation. Sakal Foundation has taken a drive.
Delhi, that is coming, no?
Yeah, right, right, right. So they have a social foundation and its name is Sakal Foundation. And they are coming up with a drive that is called as a Karuna. And their aim is to put all these poor and needy students into main stream of this online education because it's not affordable to them. So locally, we will also have to collaborate with the NGOs or other industries so that the current challenge can be overcome. When I was interacting with during one of the webinar, that was in MP. So they said that we are coming up with a community hub, which will help students to provide such gadgets. Okay, so that they can make use of it. And jinko zarurat hai, wo zarur aage aayenge aur uska use karenge. Right?
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes.
So that is also one of the solutions.
Calling from Odisha.
Okay. Yeah, you are from Odisha. Okay.
Yes, sir. I have stayed in for most of my youth period. I have stayed in Maharashtra.
Okay, great.
During my engineering and after that I was in service.
Okay,
I stayed
great.
Most of my around 9 years, 9 to 10 years at Kolhapur.
Wow.
And I can speak very well matlab Marathi also. Yes. Ajun bolu shakto hai.
Okay, chan.
In 1994, I have left Maharashtra, but still I can manage. I got many friends and.
Okay. So it was nice talking to you, Mr. Manoranjan Chaudhary. Khub bara vatla tumchashi bolun. Aani tumcha Marathi cha accent pan khub god hai. Really nice. And tumcha prashna, your question was really practical question. So we will have to collaborate because whatever challenges we are discussing, the challenges which we
have out a sponsor also.
Yes, we are discussing the challenges which we have faced in past 2 months, but there will be few challenges which will be coming in next few months. So uske liye bhi brainstorm karne ki zarurat hai. And we all have to come together. I invite you to, for the betterment of society, please come ahead. Let's discuss. My contact details are here and let's make use of the technology so that it can serve for humanity.
Sir, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. So, yes. Chan, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
And with this, I would like to thank the participants. And yes, principal was saying something.
Yeah. Sir, I'm listening very carefully since the beginning. In your very first slide, you mentioned that with this digital platform, what we can do. And yes, really, we can do wonders. So my first opinion, being while sitting in the chair of principal, I'm sure the same questions in mind. So let's be optimistic.
Yes.
So this is sudden phase come in front of us. And this is a need of this particular time. Really, we don't know whether it is going to persist, how long. Is it a phenomenon temporary or is going to be the permanent phenomenon? The very first question was raised by madam and she said, I'm applying at different places. And they said, no, we don't fill the positions because due to the financial crisis, the government has declared that in next 1 or 2 years, there will be no employment of professors. But it's not for always or it's not the permanent feature. So
yes.
If anybody is having that question in mind, please remove that fear from your mind. Now, when I'm as a teacher looking at all these electronic media and platforms, we have to take some efforts in this digital learning, preparing our notes, delivering it to the students. But other digital things or online things we are going to get out of it, they are really very wonderful. Because at the time of NAC, we are always run here and there for data collection. Right from admission of the students in last 5 years, we have to go through the ledgers, we have to check this doc and that doc and whatnot. So this will be a very good data collecting asset for all of us. Like admission data will be stored, attendance record of the students, examination record, which is very, very important and crucial for any educational institution. This is time saving. This is environmental friendly, I must say, because a lot of paper can be saved through this. And it is very easy way to maintain the records. And yes, when I look into the admission matter, being a principal, I have to look into. I think, yes, we are going to have some challenges, like while especially online money transfers, like when students will pay the fees or management or college will send some SMS to the students regarding any problem in their payments, then maybe some frauds may occur. So as far as the challenges are concerned, I feel this challenge, how safe this money transfer will be, we should take utmost care as both parties, from student side as well as from the college side. And second thing, in e-learning, yes, we will learn, we will prepare everything. But yes, our online teaching learning is not at all, I find, substitute for practicals. Because whenever students come to the laboratory and whatever material they handle, whatever experience they have in the laboratory, maybe not perfectly we could give online. So yes, with some challenges, we need to accept. So let us be optimistic. We will take this and there are some people who are already ready to serve us, like you, sir. So with the help of you and many, yes, we can definitely take up this challenge. And I think this webinar is very useful to all our teaching fraternity. Questions are well answered by you. So I personally thanks to you and your teams. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yogesh Pawar, sir.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yeah, sir.
Sorry to interrupt. I don't have any inputs from my side. But there is a question from one of my colleagues in a chat box. So can I read it out for you to consider?
Yeah, sure, sure. Please.
This question comes from Dr. R.G. Bhavne. He teaches in the Department of Physics of our college. And his question is, can we use digital smart boards for virtual classes? That is the question.
Digital smart boards for virtual classes. Yes, see, digital class board, digital boards, which I have come across is basically a replacement to the blackboards, okay, where whatever you are writing on the boards is getting captured, okay, or getting recorded or getting saved in a PDF form. Yes, it can be used for sharing. See, normally what will happen if you conduct a lecture in the classroom, okay, so you write it on a board and then you wipe it out once you finish your task, okay? So the benefit of using digital board would be whatever you write on the board can be saved in the form of PDF and can be shared with the students with a via a platform where they can refer that over a period of time. So it's a very good idea. Okay. Only thing is you will have to blend it together so that there will not be any extra effort for the teachers as well as the faculties.
Yes.
Yes, it's possible. Very well possible. And I think in some of the professional college institutions, they are doing it like this. The name I refer is NL Dalmia College, which is in Mira Road, Mumbai. Okay, so I think they are using this technique. Yeah, and they're sharing it as a snippet of board with the student. Yes.
Oh.
Yes, really nice. So it's possible. Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So I'm very thankful to all the participants as well as the organizing committee. and our respected panelist, okay, for all the efforts to making it happen, and all the participants who joined us on the Zoom as well as on the YouTube for making this session successful with your interaction. So thank you very much. Have a very nice day to all of you. Yeah, bye bye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Now,
Yes, Principal
ma'am wants to say something.
Thank you,
ma'am.
Go ahead.
I would now request to our the vice principal of our college, Professor Dr. Vijay Patil, sir, for a vote of thanks. Dr. Vijay Patil, sir.
It is my proud privilege to propose the vote of thanks to all who have helped us in making this national webinar such as a resounding success. First of all, I would like to propose a hearty vote of thanks to our honorable patrons, Professor P.P. Patil, Vice Chancellor, Professor P.P. Mahulikar, Pro Vice Chancellor, Professor B.V. Pawar, Acting Registrar, Kavitri Bahinabai Chaudhary, North Maharashtra University, Jalgaon. I also take this opportunity to thank Professor Satish Deshpande, Joint Director, Higher Education, Jalgaon Region, Jalgaon. I also express my sincere thanks to Honorable Dr. Subhat Chaudhary, President, Leva Educational Union, Jalgaon, and all the members of the Executive Council, Leva Educational Union, Jalgaon. I express my heartfelt thanks to distinguished speaker, Mr. Yogesh Pawar, Director Digital IT Solution Private Limited, who delivered a very informative talk on digital transportation in current education system and making this webinar thought-provoking. I also thank his team for helping us to organize this webinar. I would like to express our profound gratitude to our principal, Dr. Gauri Rane, who always stands us on every occasion. Lastly, thanks to all participants who attended this webinar from all over India. Thanks for your spontaneous participation. Once again, thanks to all. For final announcement, I now hand over the session to Priyanka.
Okay, thank you. Thank you all the participants.
Yes, so yes, we can call this end of this successful interaction. It was very sweet, very good. It was pleasure talking to you all. Thank you and bye-bye.